fiance was outside and he just said, run, run, run. Oh yeah, so I ran. All the other people that are affected by it, it's just, but all the people that came together too to help is awesome to know that we have a community like that.
Now at 6, devastation, destruction, now the rebuild of lives and homes. The tornado that ripped through an area south of St. Louis overnight brought winds, the National Weather Service says, of up to 130 miles per hour. The towns of Glen Allen and Grassy, just west of Cape Girardeau, took the brunt.
And here's the latest at 6. We've got new information from Bollinger County, where Governor Mike Parson has been touring. We know tonight 5 people are dead, among them a 16-year-old and 18-year-old. 5 other people are also hurt.
Governor Mike Parson says President Biden is offering federal help, and the scope of the damage is vast. Preliminary search crews report 12 structures destroyed and at least 75 damaged. Recovery will take months. The National Weather Service says they have found evidence showing this was an EF2 tornado that hit Bollinger County.
And tonight, News 4 is there on the ground. Our team of reporters hearing and seeing the damage firsthand. We're going to start here at 6 o'clock with our John Kipper, who's been with Governor Parson within the last hour.
Yeah, Sam, just a few minutes ago, I had a literal dumpster fire behind me. This was a planned fire, and just to give you some perspective, that white propane tank was hit by the tornado this morning. It was leaking fuel, and for safety reasons, they burned out that tank. Now, while it doesn't look great, this is not close to the worst thing to happen to the area today. The Bollinger County coroner told News 4 that out of 5 fatalities, one is a 16-year-old and another is an 18-year-old. The oldest to pass away is 62 years old. 2 children were also injured, according to the coroner, and it's unclear when these people's identities are going to be released, with the coroner telling me it's not up to him. Governor Mike Parson toured the damage in a helicopter. When he got back, he told the media that President Biden gave him a call.
The President of the United States called me on the way here. Wanted to make sure that all the people here knew that he was thinking about them. Anything he could do to help, he offered those services, and he wanted to especially thank all the emergency people that were on the ground doing their jobs here.
Now, Governor Parson did say that he's from a small town like the ones that were affected by the tornado, and that he knows these communities will help each other out and that they will rebuild. And at that press conference, they mentioned 12 structures are totally gone after the tornado. Reporting live in Bollinger County, John Kipper, News 4.
John, thank you. Recovery efforts are already beginning, but this storm, as you just saw, left significant damage. And take a look at this picture from our sister station in this area. This is all of that's left of the Glen Allen Fire Department, now just a pile of rubble and plywood. Our coverage continues here at 6 with our Alex Gall. He has been in the area throughout the day, hearing the stories of those impacted tonight.
Sam, Corey, we are now in the center part of the community of Glen Allen. This is just west of Woodland High School. And you can see this is what used to be the local fire station. Now it's been reduced to rubble. And across this area, we've seen several downed trees, power lines littering the ground. And you can even see some of the siding torn off of these homes in this community, this small community here in southeast Missouri. That home across the street with trees snapped in half, and the roof has been completely torn off of that one on the top of the hill. Now, this is a scene we've seen across southeast Missouri, these small communities here in Bollinger County. The tornado came through here at about 3 to 4 a.m. this morning. Now they are receiving help from at least 20 different EMS agencies, many of them local volunteers. The Masters family of 6 were able to take shelter in this home right before the storm hit.
There was a pressure like you wouldn't believe. I hollered at the wife, told her to get the kids to the basement. And we got down in the basement, and by that time, stuff was crashing, hitting the house. You could hear trees breaking. Transformer blew right out here, right outside the house. Sounded like a bomb went off.
Amongst the rubble here, things are still standing, like that solitary American flag in front of a local church. Now, authorities want people of the public to stay out of this affected area here if you are not a volunteer or a member who lives in these communities. In Bollinger County, Alex Gall, News 4.
This tornado was one of a few from last night's storms. First Alert meteorologist Kristen Cornett is here. And Kristen, you have the newest information from the National Weather Service.
Yeah, so first I want to show you just the storm reports across the region. Each of these indicate one tornado, several here northeast of Quincy. Quite a lot to our north and parts of Iowa, parts of Illinois. But it's this one to our south that we've been focusing on. And this is the information from the Paducah National Weather Service, who went out and surveyed this storm today. And based on their preliminary results, they're saying high-end EF2 tornadoes we're looking at here. So that means the estimated peak winds about 130 miles per hour. Out